When we had our 75th birthday anniversary 2 years ago, the center director here, Lyman Thorsteinson, was a bit of a history buff, and he felt it was important to write down the history of this laboratory, how it got started, where we've been in the past, where we are today, and where we might be going. It all started in 1935 with one man in a basement laboratory over at what's now the National Marine Fisheries Research Center over by the Montlake Bridge, adjacent to the University of Washington. So we have a loose, well, I shouldn't say loose, a confederation of some fairly large field stations operated out of the Seattle Center here. And the main research that goes on in the Seattle Center is the core of the original fish disease work that was started. That's how this laboratory started. We still maintain this capability. Well, this research center is an interesting place. It because the environmental legislation that Congress passed kept changing and broadening, especially during the 70s, during the Nixon administration, the Endangered Species Act was passed, the National Environmental Policy Act was passed, Clean Water Act was passed. Well, as a result, the information needs, technical information needs of the federal government kept increasing and getting broader. First, the facility itself. When this facility was constructed in 1994, it was designed to include a biological level 3 containment laboratory, which enables us to work with fish disease pathogens and human pathogens for that matter, like anthrax, for example, if it's needed. We have a marine field station where you can follow the salmon out into the marine environment under controlled conditions. You won't see that capability anyplace else. The real secret that we have is not the equipment, not the buildings, not the laboratories, but it's the people. There have been many, many world-class biologists in the past. We have world-class biologists today. We have biologists coming up that are going to be world leaders in their field. So we have it all. Well, there are two things that I learned. I learned a lot by writing it, of course, and I got a new appreciation for just how capable the guys were that started this whole project back in 1935, and how far seeing they were, and what high standards of excellence they held themselves to, and the people that worked for them to. And the second thing is, I've been impressed by writing. When you actually start writing it down, it clarifies things in your mind, and you see that there is actually a story taking place here right before our eyes. We, the people here right now, see only a small part of it, but we're all part of something greater than ourselves. And we get so busy and tied up on our own projects, we don't often have time to reflect on the fact that you're part of a legacy. The work you're doing is part of a legacy, a standard of excellence that's goes way, way back to before you were born, and that the work that we're doing today will connect us to the work that remains yet to be done. I ponder about what will this place be like in another 75 years. I think it'll still be here because the natural resource problems that the nation faces, that Congress has asked us to help solve by passing conservation legislation, the These problems are getting ever more complicated, more complex. Who knows what the place is going to be like? The only thing we know is it'll be different than it is today.